Today, my dear friends, we are going to speak about the second part of label reading. I really hope you enjoyed the YouTube seminar on the first part, theoretical. This is an exercise that we do all together to understand how to properly read a label. You may say, but why, Marco? You are wasting our time. No, don't worry. This is very important to be a nutritional consultant, to be able to fully analyze products, even if we know that the label is just partial, job, because then the product has to be tried in vivo on the animal. But still, label reading, it's the most powerful weapon you have when you try to explain to customers the quality of the product and also to make comparison among products. That's why in the very first seminar about the theory, I show you two important calculations. The first one, it's maybe a little bit less important for making a comparison among dry pet food, because dry pet food is, regulated to be always more or less the same moisture. Being the same moisture, you can make easy comparison among other values, protein, fats, and so on. Because in any case, the water that is lost during digestion is the same. Let's say that generally speaking, the moisture of dry pet food is around 8-9%. Cat food is a little bit drier, dog food is a little bit wetter, but the story is the same. So more or less you can compare foods without making calculation. It's in any case worth to repeat how to calculate the dry matter and all nutrients on dry matter, because as you saw in the first seminar, this is very important to make comparison among wet food and dry food. So the calculation is very easy. Out from the total, we take out the moisture and we have the dry matter, which is the part of food that gives nutrient and gives calories. So it's the part of food on which we base our calculation when we want to establish a feeding dose. Water is not important. I mean, water is very important, but in order to calculate the feeding amount is not important. It's just a confounding factor. That's why we need to always think about the intake of dry matter. Then, after the calculation of the dry matter, which is 100, the total minus the moisture, we can calculate the amount of nutrient based on the dry matter just by dividing the protein, the fats, the fiber, the ash, whatever nutrient, even calcium, phosphorus, whatever, even energy, which is not strictly speaking a nutrient, but it depends from nutrients, dividing it by the percentage of dry matter. So, for example, in a pet food, the dry pet food with the 9% of moisture, the dry matter is 100 minus 9, 91. And then maybe protein is 25. So the protein on dry matter is 25 divided by 0.91, divided by 91%. And then you will have a number that is slightly higher than 25, maybe is 26. This is the amount of protein on dry matter. More is the water, less is the dry matter. So when you divide a nutrient by a very small dry matter, you will have very much increase. That's why, for example, 9% of protein in a wet food with 72% of water will result in 40% of protein on the dry matter. I know I'm going a little bit quick, but this is very thoroughly explained in my first label reading, the theoretical part. Okay. Now, even more important, because it's not essential nutrient and because nobody will tell you what is the amount of carbohydrate into a pet food, because it's not to be written by the law unless you want to make a voluntary declaration like we do in our holistic, because holistic is the top off the top. That's why we decided to declare even the starch content. But in the case you are facing other pet food and you want to understand what is the carbohydrate content of that food, the calculation that I explain in the first label reading part is 100, the total, minus the main five, let's say, items of the analytical compound: protein, fat, fiber, which is part of carbohydrate but not digestible, moisture, and ash. When you do this, what remains are carbohydrates, which is 98% starch. Okay, this is very important because, as you know, starch, it's considered to be a filler into the pet food. So more starch you have, less is the cost of the formula, which means more starch you have, less is the goodness of the product for a carnivore. Probably we can recognize that too high starch is a problem. Sometimes for some breeds, very selected breeds, it's the opposite, because protein and fat can be quite heavy to digest. So cooked starch, increased amount of starch, can be beneficial. But this is another story. About the cost of the formula, more starch you have, less is the cost. That's why to make a comparison among pet food is important to calculate the starch content. How? I repeat, 100 minus protein, fat, fiber, ash, and moisture. Let's see in vivo how this is done. First, I will show you two different labels, European and American. You must know the difference to be able to make a proper comparison. European label, this is our product. European label, what you need to know is that it's divided in three parts. The first part is the composition. It's just the list of ingredients from the one with higher weight to the one with lower amount. This is weighted before extrusion. So when, for example, the fresh meat, it still has a big amount of water, of moisture inside. Composition, ingredients. Then additives per kilo. European Union is much, much more strict than American food about additives, because they are essential nutrient in dog and cat. And because sometimes, especially at an industrial level, you cannot ensure the proper intake of these very sensitive nutrients with the composition, with the ingredient. That's why they ask us producer to state in a different section of the label, which is additives per kilo, together with the EU number. Guys, this is not a black magic formula. This is just the number with which those additives are inscribed in the catalog. It's not saying this is bad or this is good. It's just the number. If you don't find the number, it means the label is old and should be updated. And you will see that on the market, majority of producers, they still didn't update the label with the EU number. Here you also find, as last part, the antioxidants, preservatives. When you find just the word antioxidant, it means they are declaring by category, and it means they could use whatever. They can use BHA, they can use BHT. I have a seminar on YouTube about fat preservation in which I speak about those antioxidants. And then the third part of the label is the analytical compound. What is important to know about this, and I explained in the first part of the training, in the theoretical part, is that this is the sum of all nutrients brought by all raw materials. So for example, 38 of protein, in our case, it's 99% from meat. But in other cases, with other pet food producers, where there is massive use of, for example, peas or lentils or cereals or whatever source of starch, they also bring protein. So if you have, for example, 20% of peas in a formula and the 20% of peas is protein. The 20% of 20% is protein from vegetal origin. This is very important to understand. Same is for all other nutrients. In very evolute labels like our, we even have the splitting of the energy from which nutrient proceed. So for example, you see the metabolized energy calculated with the Chen method, which is the most advanced method for calculation of metabolized energy, and then the amount of energy brought by protein, in this case 34%, and the amount of energy brought by fat, 40%.
So the rest is coming from?
So like Hans says, the rest is coming from carbohydrates, starch, because it's the third nutrient that bring energy. This is the same label, very same product, but with the label according to AFCO, according to the American institution, the American, let's say, yes, institution that regulates pet food. Here, there is no additive per kilo. There is not. Because they list, if they put, and according to AFCO legislation, you may even avoid, if you want later on, I will tell you how it's possible to avoid. But if you really want to avoid and maybe save the cost of the formula, you can avoid to write the additives. But in general, they consider it a ingredient. So you see that in the first part you still see dehydrated chicken, blah blah blah, without the numbers. AFCO doesn't want to declare the amount. So again, European labels are much more specific because they can tell the amount of ingredient. If you don't find, probably either it's not declared voluntarily, either it's AFCO label, it's American label. And then you see there is any kind of supplement, vitamin A supplement, vitamin D supplement, etc., etc. This is because it's the same label of before, but compliant to different regulation. What it's called analytical components in the European label, here it's guaranteed analysis. Why guaranteed? Because they guarantee that there is at least a minimum or a maximum of those. While we declare the average, they declare the minimum and the maximum. Actually, you see beside, for example, crude protein, minimum 37%. Crude fiber, maximum 1.5%, etc. Okay? So this is important to understand because it makes a little bit different the production of pet food. For example, American producer, if they declare minimum 20% of protein in the pet food, one production can be 21, one production can be 25. So very big variability among formulas. In Europe, it's more strict because we have average and tolerance. In any case, let's go directly to the real labels. I did a real example and I will, like three example, and I will make with you exercise of label reading. So what you can see into the label. First label is the label of a very famous super premium. This is a pet food, and we did in the first theoretical part of the label reading the difference between economic, premium, super premium, ultra premium. This is, let's say, what multinational consider super premium, the top of their production, which is in our point of view, let's say a lower quality super premium. We will see that we compete with this product with our equilibrium line, which is out of the three main line of the USA, let's say a little bit the cheaper. So let's see, first of all, you see super premium, minimum, maximum. This is American label. This is a label according to AFCO, because there is minimum and maximum. Also, you see in the composition, vitamins and trace minerals listed by category, not even listed by the real additive. Again, having vitamin and minerals inside the composition tell us this is American label. Okay, Now you see there is no starch. Let's try to calculate starch with the formula that we all know. 100 minus protein, fat, fiber, moisture. You have to know that, and ash. You have to know that in AFCO compliant labels, ash can be avoided. So American producer can avoid to declare ash, minerals. So we will, let's say, keep, let's say, 6-7% of ash, even if probably in this product is lower because of the use of vegetal source of protein. Let's keep ash 7%, 6%. So 100 minus 24, it's 66, minus 15 here, it's 51. Minus 3.5 x 48%, minus 10% moisture maximum, let's say 10%, normally it's 8, 39, minus 6 of ash, 33. Did I make the right calculation? No, sorry, because I said at the beginning 66, but it was 76, because 100 minus 24 is 76. So not 33, but 43. So 43% of carbohydrates in a pet food that is called super premium. It means the starch, the sugar, the complex sugar, it's almost a half of the recipe in a super premium, guys, in a super premium, almost a half of the recipe, 43%. Now let's see the quality. We saw that the amount, the values are not very high because we can recognize that the minimum amount of protein for an adult dog is 18%, for example. Here it's 24, so it's very close to the minimum. But we saw this also not just directly evaluating the nutrients, but we also saw this by subtracting the nutrients from the total and having the final amount of sugar, of starch, 43%. Now, let's see those nutrients from which raw material proceed, because it's important the amount, but it's also important the quality. Maybe even more important. First ingredient, chicken byproduct meal. Meal is the form, the physical form in which they receive the product. It's powder, it's flour, meal. Byproduct means the proceeding, from where this protein proceed. Chicken byproduct in this sense are, for example, visceras, especially intestines, that are washed, because at least in Europe you have to wash the intestines because it's not allowed for feeding the intestinal content. And then you grind and you dry, and that's why it comes in form of meal. So you see, not exactly the best source of protein, but guys, there is a but, because they were able to list chicken byproduct meal in the first position, but it's a trick, because with the 24% of protein, you cannot expect this protein come from meat. It's just too low. What we have? We have brown rice, and then brewer's rice, and then wheat, and then oats. So 1, 2, 3, 4 different four different kind of cereal source of starch source. This is the technique called splitting. Splitting, let's say, ingredient that could be listed as cereal. If you list this ingredient by category, cereal, you will have it in the first position. And that makes sense, because it's just impossible to have meat in first position and having 43% of starch. It's just impossible. So where is this starch coming from? Here it is. Brown rice, brewer's rice is rice after brewing. So it's a rice that lost all its nutrient. Rice doesn't have very much nutrient, big amount. It is especially very digestible, the most digestible starch. But nutrients, well, brewer's rice, it's even poorer in nutrients because it is used after brewing, after production of beer, after the nutrients are extracted. And then wheat, and then oats. And then another source of protein, corn gluten meal. Corn gluten is important protein for multinational because they are able to push the amount of protein without increasing the ash. Corn gluten is a pure protein. 60% is protein, 40% is starch, but no ashes, very, very limited amount of minerals inside. In byproducts, there is much more mineral. So if you add corn gluten to a formula, you are giving some digestibility, maybe not very high quality raw material in terms of protein quality. We also have a seminar on YouTube about protein quality in pet food. But especially you are keeping down the amount of ash. So if you see corn gluten or vegetal isolate protein or soy protein, they are using it to decrease the amount of ash into the formula. And so they are able to use a very poor quality meat inside. And then we can say there is also wheat gluten used with the same purpose. Chicken fat, okay, chicken fat is a good source of fat. Fish oil is a good source of fat. And then also vegetable oil. You don't have, strictly speaking, the necessity of using vegetable oil in this formula because vegetable oil, the only thing that can give, under nutritional point of view, is some amount of omega-6, linoleic acid, essential for dog. But with all the in cereals that you already have inside, you see brown rice, brewer's rice, wheat, oats, and so on, you already have this amount of essential fat. Essential fatty acid, omega-6. So no reason. The unique reason is that it costs less and then it push the amount of fat, but not the quality. And actually you see in EPA and DHA, they are very low, 0.24 and 0.1. Even if they put fish oil, they are not able to make high quantity of essential fatty acids, omega-3. Okay, let's say that this we can already we can make more, let's say, analysis of this label. For example, we can see that they are adding the lysine, the tyrosine in isolate form because they know they don't have enough amino acids in their raw material. The raw material they are using is very poor. So they need to add isolate chemical amino acids. Essential amino acids that otherwise they could not label their pet food as complete. Okay, so to resume, American label, 43% of carbohydrate, so clearly not expensive label, splitting of sensitive ingredients in order to not appear as first ingredient, cereals, brown rice, brewer's rice, wheat, oat groats, the use of poor animal source raw material, byproducts from chicken, and then the use of vegetal source of protein to keep down the amount of ash, not declared, and push the amount of protein, which are those raw material, corn gluten, wheat gluten. This is traditional super premium. You will see with these guys, we can very, very, very easily compete with our equilibrium because our equilibrium will have superior source of raw material, fresh meat, natural antioxidants, all the characteristics of our production like steam cooking. So our product will be even with the same values, with the same amount of protein, of fat, etc. We will have much more quality. The protein will be brought by meat, not by byproducts, okay? Then another example. This is organic grain-free. organic grain free. And you may say, wow, organic grain free, for probably the best product on the market. Well, it is not, because this is marketing. Grain free, it just means you can avoid the grains. And organic, you can have just a few ingredients that are organic and put the let's say the kind of source of those ingredients. You can see organic turkey, organic peas, and then turkey meal. Turkey meal is not organic. They just buy a meal byproduct, which is not organic, but then they write organic on the bag because they have a few ingredients that are organic. In terms of analysis, okay, this is, first of all, this is European label. You see there is not a minimum and maximum. There is, in the composition, there is no mineral and vitamins. If we make a calculation of carbohydrates, it will come more or less the same of before, 45% of starch. So now you see, what is the reason of having a grain-free if the amount of starch is so high? The reason of having a grain-free is to avoid grain, the main source of starch. But why to put so much other source of starch not proceeding from grain? 100 minus 23 is 77, minus 14 is 63, minus 7.6 is 56, minus 4 is 54, minus moisture, which is a European label and we can avoid, let's say, 9%, is 44-45%, again, it's starch. Come on, this is a grain-free and should be with more protein and fat. But in fact, it's the same of before. That's why I call it super premium grain-free. Okay? And so you see organic turkey in first position, but then organic peas. Peas has a big amount of protein. So if you put so close to the top, it means a big part of this protein, 23%, is from peas. And then turkey meal, we already spoke about this product, this ingredient, then organic tapioca, and then organic pea flour. Guys, this is another example of splitting. What is the reason of declaring peas and pea flour in two different places? The unique reason is that I don't want the pea to appear as first ingredient, okay? So splitting, very typical attitude of companies that want to hide something, basically. I will not go on because we can say more or less the same of before, use of vegetal oils, canola oil, very cheap, sunflower oil, not so cheap, but and so on. Pea starch again, you see there is still pea starch. So this product probably is based on peas. And if you follow our training in YouTube about proteins, you will see that this is not exactly the best nutritional approach because protein from peas are lacking, for example, taurine. And then that's why they have to add in a separate form, taurine. It's not like us that we integrate taurine because we want to have the best pet food in the world. They integrate taurine because with this amount of protein and with protein from peas, they don't have enough even precursor to produce taurine. You will see in our seminar of ProCore. Okay, so this product, we will jump, but we can say the same of before. Let's go directly to a very important product that is one of the leaders of the market. It's a grain-free also. Sorry, it's a grain-free, and it's a, this time it's a hyper-protein grain-free. Okay, hyper-protein grain-free. As you can see, this is still a American label with minimum, maximum. Obviously, in this case, it will be you can see immediately the amount of protein, the amount of fat. Before we had the average of 25, 26, 24. Now we are much above. This is a good product. 38% of protein. So let's try to see how many carbs there are in this product. 100 minus 38 minus, which is a 62, minus 18, minus 4%, minus 12% of moisture, even if we know that, let's put 10, because 12% is really too much. It's just because of American label. And then ash is not declared, but most probably here it's 8 to 9%, so because it's a very rich in meat product. 22% of carbohydrates. You see the difference of a ultra premium and super premium? Yeah. Super premium, 40-45% of carbohydrates. Ultra premium, 20-25% of carbohydrates. Almost a half. This is very important difference to notice because it's the main gap in the market. Premium and super premium are quite close, but super premium and ultra premium are very, very distant. Okay? So here we see, what we see about this beautiful product? We see beautiful marketing, really, because as you can see, the first probably 20 items are animal origin products. So the idea that majority of proteins come from meat. There is a but, like always. As you see, I highlight in red some ingredient that suffer again splitting. Whole green peas, whole navy beans, red lentils, pinto beans, chickpeas, green lentils, alfalfa. All these leguminous plants belonging to family of Fabaceae, they are very rich in proteins. 25, 30, 40% of protein. So even if you put amount that splitted goes very down into the label, the amount of proteins that they bring to the formula is quite high. It's almost 10% out of the 38 total. So out of the 38 total, the first ingredients, which are meats or meat byproduct, because you can see there are also meat byproducts that I put in bold. At the end, it's 30% from meat and the rest is from vegetal. That's why this is American product. That's why this kind of products in last 3 years, as I explained in my first part regarding protein on YouTube, were accused of creating dilated cardiomyopathy in dogs. A pathology that is due to the lack of taurine on one side, but also the lack of precursor for production of taurine, which is methionine and cysteine, amino acids that are not present in Fabaceae plants, but in cereals. It may look amazing, but these plants, they don't have some amino acid, which are not essential, but need to be sourced in certain quantity if we want to use them to produce taurine, that are not present in this protein, but are present in cereal protein. So the grain-free products with the high amount of vegetal protein are dangerous. And since there is no obligation for producer to put taurine in dog food because it's not considered essential nutrient, in some case, there is not willing of adding taurine. You will see that our product, the same product of the same category, will have not only majority of protein from animal origin and not this big amount of vegetal source of starch and protein splitted in order to hide them into the label, but will have a very big amount also of taurine. So protein from meat already presenting taurine plus addition of taurine. This is our nutritional approach, okay? Then what we can see in this label, good amount of omega-6, good amount of omega-3 even, 0.8%. To be honest, not very high amount of EPA and DHA. They are omega-3, but not the unique. There are also some omega-3, like the gamma-linolenic acid, which is present in vegetal. It's not the omega-3 from fish, the most noble. And that's why 0.2 of DHA plus 0.2 of EPA, it makes 0.4. And what is the rest of 0.4 of omega-3 that means to make 0.8? It's most probably omega-3 from vegetal, gamma-linolenic. You will see in our product the amount of EPA and DHA make almost the whole total of omega-3. It means that our omega-3 are higher and that the total amount is from fish oil, not from vegetal source of oils. Okay? Then, there are many other things that can be said about this label, but I would make it too heavy. So let's move on and let's go directly to see our product. And then in the end, if you want, we can compare and put side by side our products and the products of competitors. So to see what kind of tool in terms of label you have in your hands. Alleva range, finally, our range of product. Dog formulas, as you know, we have Alleva Natural. We are about to produce Alleva Care, Alleva Holistic. We will talk more in specific. We add Alleva Equilibrium. And then in cat formulas, also we have Holistic. We are about to issue the Super Premium Equilibrium and we'll also have Alleva Care. But let's see in the specific. Starting from, let's say, the lower, even if I don't like to speak about the lower or higher, but in terms of, for example, protein, fat, and at the end, in terms of cost of formula, this line, the equilibrium line, it's the lowest in our range, but can be used and explained in a functional way, which is very important to give added value. Let's see what are the characteristics of the line and then the products in the specific. This line has been formulated to be used as sensitive line. By the law, there is no definition of sensitive. There is no definition of functional. So this line still is a maintenance. Complete dry pet food. Okay, maintenance. But we decided to call them sensitive, sensitive pork, sensitive lamb, sensitive fish, and even a single product for weight control, which is a light, in order to give a functionality to the line. Because it may look strange, but even if it is the, let's say, cheapest line of our range, the characteristic of having lower protein and lower fat make them more suitable for animals that have a problem, for example, with digestion or with skin. That's why sensitive. Because if you will see my seminars on YouTube, you will see that protein and fats, especially when we have sick animals, they are the nutrients that mostly create problem. In case of allergy, for example, is protein. Everybody know. That's why we go to select a specific source of protein to counteract adverse food reaction. And in terms of gastrointestinal problem, the main issue is with fat, because fat delay the gastric empty, because fat, if the intestine is not well set, can be fermented to let's say, substance that irritate the intestine and produce diarrhea, etc., etc. Or even if you have the exocrine pancreas insufficiency, which need a low-fat diet, you all know the concept of gastrointestinal low-fat, it's because fat can be, in some cases, difficult to digest. So a product that is cheaper, guys, it's cheaper, but it's cheaper because it has a moderate amount of protein, a moderate amount of fat, and therefore, and also a selected source of protein and fat, make this product suitable for sensitive animal, okay? So use it in a sensitive way. What has in addition to the range to, let's say, increase the quality of the range? Well, first of all, the same characteristic of our production. As I said during the first training, steam cooking, so a better preservation for the raw material. Also the use of natural antioxidant in all products, all line, even in a super premium. Guys, the super premium of before, the one from multinational, doesn't have natural antioxidants, doesn't have steam cooking. And also, as we will see in next slide, he doesn't have fresh meat. He doesn't have addition of fruits and phytonutrients. So in this case, we add in the whole line cranberry and blueberry because they are very rich in proanthocyanidins, antioxidants, very strong, powerful, natural antioxidant, close to flavonoids, let's say. And then apple and carrots, very good source, not only of vitamins, as everybody knows, but also of fiber, soluble fiber for intestine. So very selected phytonutrients. Let's see. These are the two puppies. You have two puppies based on lamb and on fish. So you don't have chicken puppy in this range, which is, I think, a huge advantage for a range entry level without chicken. Huge advantage. First ingredient, almost a half of the recipe is the meat, lamb, or the fish, as you can see, 45 and 42, which result in very high amount of protein, 30%. It's important. Puppies need protein to build up muscle, to build up enzymes, to build up blood cells, to build up hormones, okay? So proteins is very important. And protein from dehydrated meat and fresh meat, not existing in other super premium from multinational. No byproducts, high quality meats. Then rice, 25%. In this case, we also put corn. There is only in few formulas, but, and we will produce a seminar about carbohydrates, the corn we select, it's sourced just outside our factory. If I turn the camera, now it's but there are fields cultivated with rice, with corn. As you may know, you must know that the problem that the pet food industry has with corn is not just about the price. It's about the preservation. Corn is, when you select and you provide the corn from South America, is badly conserved, and it produces molds, it produces fungi that in turn produce toxins, aflatoxins, that are very dangerous. That's why people, even if they don't know, are afraid about corn. But nutritionally speaking, corn, it's more or less like all other cereals. It has a moderate to low quantity of protein. The fat that it contains omega-6, but omega-6 also are essential fatty acids. So corn by itself is not bad. The problem of pet food with corn is that majority is provided from South America and conserved very badly in 2 months time of transit to Europe, big contamination, big aflatoxins. Our corn is fully non-GMO, completely not GMO, always it is tested, of course, but it's naturally free from toxins because it's not conserved, it's not preserved, okay? Then chicken fat, fiber from peas, etc., chicory root, chicory root, it provides inulin and fructooligosaccharides, very important prebiotic for the intestine. What is a prebiotic? The name pre means before. Biotic, bios in Latin, means life. So it's something that you provide, you have to provide to the animal before he develop life. Which life? The probiotic, bacterias, good bacterias in intestine. So prebiotic, like inulin, like fructooligosaccharides, like mannanooligosaccharides, certain kind of, are prebiotic to let the intestine develop correctly, probiotic, microflora. And then the fruits and vegetables, and then glucosamine and chondroitin, not in super high amount, because this is entry-level product, but still 500 and 400 milligrams per kilo. So in some sense, much higher than some ultra premium products, okay? So, and then very high amount, we can see from an analytical compound, high amount of protein, high amount of fats, because these are the main nutrients for puppies, for energy, for playing, for growing, which result in a good amount of energy, more than 4,000 calories. So very rich product. Same is with the fish formula, in which there is no corn, it's just rice. So even more quality approach to this puppy formula. Very high in this case of omega-3. You see 1.6% of omega-3 because of the massive use of fish oil, because of the presence of fish meat inside the product. So very high amount of essential fatty acids, omega-3, anti-inflammatory, but also important in puppy food because they can help development of nervous system of puppies. Very important, omega-3. And then we have adult products. We have sensitive lamb, we have sensitive fish, we have sensitive pork with moderate amount of protein and fat, but still, if we make calculation, and we will make just once as example, you will see that it's not so high. It is high because it's entry-level product, but probably it's lower than the super premium of competitors. So 100 minus... minus 26 is 74, minus 16 is 58, minus 3 is 55, minus 7 is 48, minus moisture, 9% in dog product, is 49. 49 or 39, in any case, not more than super premium of competitors, even less, but with the fresh meat, with phytonutrients, with chondroitin, with glucosamine, steam cooked, monoprotein. So guys, many, many advantages in this line compared to the super premium of multinational. We have also one product based on chicken and fish in order to have a battle product, because this is obviously, this will have a price that is competitive, but still very high quality because dehydrated meat and because of the presence of fish that provide some omega. And then the weight control. What are the characteristics of weight control? First of all, high quantity of protein, because protein can give a satiety feeling because they have a glycemic index zero. And then low level of fat, 9%. As you can imagine, fat are the most, let's say, energetic nutrient. That's why we have to reduce if we want to have a product that control weight. And very high amount of fiber, 6%. In this case, Well, fiber, the crude fiber, decrease the energetic density of the formula. The fiber is not digested by dogs and cats, so it doesn't provide energy. More you increase fiber, lower is the energy density of the formula. Not only fiber, especially the soluble fiber, not the crude one, is able to catch water into the stomach. Water increase the volume of the food and the stomach feel full. The animal will not have the willing of eating more and more. Okay, so a product that is based on protein, fiber, lower fat. Also, it's important what for this product? It's important that the protein, the carbohydrate come from low glycemic index carbohydrate, like brown rice. As you can see, brown rice, pea starch, they are all slowly digestible carbohydrates. Very important to give satiety. Very high level of glucosamine chondroitin. This is important for animals that are overweight, most probably if they use a weight control, and does need to preserve articulation. So, as you can see, technical, very technical approach, even for super premium entry-level products with fresh meat, with botanicals, with natural antioxidants that here I didn't list because there is no the additive list, but also with the taurine and with the carnitine. Taurine for the wellness of the heart, the vision, the reproduction, carnitine for the correct usage of fats. You will find all this information in my nutritional trainings on YouTube. This was the first line. Then in the end, we will make maybe, if you want, a comparison with the same product of competitor, just to highlight even more the pluses we have. This is our intermediate line. I would like to look at this line like a lower ultra premium or very upper super premium. This is Alleva Natural. Alleva Natural, which is even higher, of course, in protein, in fats, because this is what carnivore needs. You will see the amount of carbohydrate here. It's not 45%, it's 35%. So it's, let's say, a upper, really upper super premium. With brown rice and with pumpkin as a phytonutrient. Beautiful ingredient, which if you look in literature, scientific literature, you will find any kind of benefit given by pumpkin. But what I have to say as a scientist is to promote exclusively the intestinal wellness, at least in public, because this is what the fiber of pumpkin does, to care about intestine, which is a very sensitive topic. 5% of dry pulp of pumpkin. Then, very high amount of chondroprotectors, very high amount of taurine, carnitine. In this product, we have enough taurine to feed a cat, okay? In a dog product, even if it's not mandatory, we decide to put enough taurine to even feed a cat, just to give you idea of the quality of the formula. Natural antioxidants, steam cook, etc., etc. Let's see the formulation. This is a puppy product. In this case, we have puppy chicken in the commercial line. In the new breeder line, which is called essential, but it's the same of natural, we will have also lamb. But in this moment, in a commercial line, we have only chicken, but with good segmentation, because we have puppy mini, puppy medium, puppy maxi. The same we will find in chicken adult, chicken mini, chicken medium, chicken maxi. Not only the difference in the size of the kibble, but also in nutrients. Mini products will be more energetic, higher in protein, higher in fat. Maxi product will be less energetic. Why? Because maxi animals, large dog, when they are puppy, they don't need too high energy. Otherwise, they grow too quick and they have problem with articulation. Same is in adult age. Big dogs, they don't need a very high amount of energy, because otherwise they can get weight and stress their vital tissue, vital organs. So a moderate amount of protein, of fat, of calcium and phosphorus, very important, especially in puppy. So to take a close look to the label, we always start with dehydrated high quality meat, and then the fresh meat, very high quantity of fresh meat. And then the brown rice, again, low glycemic index, noble source of starch. Then the chicken fat, because this product has to be rich in fat. You see, there is no splitting of ingredients. There is no brown rice, brewer's rice, rice, corn, whatever. There is brown rice and pea starch. They are the unique two source of starch. And they cannot be included in a single word cereals, because pea starch is not cereal. And because it's just starch, not protein from peas, only the starch, only the carbohydrate to bind the kibble and to give a slower digestibility of the starch, of the sugar. So a low glycemic index. Then dried pumpkin, 5%, very big amount, very expensive phytonutrients in big amount. But we only want the best for the intestine of our beloved. And then again, source of fiber like dried beetroot pulp, fish oil, never missing. In this line, fish oil is never missing. Even more important in puppy range. Do you remember that ultra premium of before with 0.8% of omega-3, of which 0.2% of EPA and 0.2% of DHA? Look at this product. It's not the same ultra premium range, but look at the omega-3, 0.9. And look at the EPA and DHA, 0.3, 0.4. The sum is 0.7. It means the gamma linolenic omega-3 is just 0.2, because 0.9 minus 0.7 is 0.2. So very big added value with the fish oil, with essential omega-3. Look at the amount of glucosamine and chondroitin. It's almost the same of a joint diet in a prescription range. Very high quality product, based on protein, based on fats, and low glycemic index carbohydrate, with pumpkin, with high integration of glucosamine, chondroitin, taurine, which is not listed because, again, I didn't list the additive list, carnitine, 1,000 milligrams of taurine per kilo, 500 milligrams of carnitine. You will not find easily those amount of additive, functional additive in a dog food. So, puppy, mini, medium, maxi. Adult, mini, medium, maxi, again, with very high amount of protein fat. If we make the calculation here, it's probably 32, 35 maximum of carbohydrate. Okay, so 1/3 of the formula, not a half of the formula like super premium from competitors. We have products with fish, and in this case only fish, and you can see the amount of omega-3 in this product. Look, 1.7%, huge amount of omega-3 in this product, because they proceed from fish, dehydrated fish, fresh fish. This fish is a wild-caught fish. It's not a farmed salmon. Never trust salmon, guys, never trust salmon. Salmon would be good, would be very good, but in this moment it's all farming. And when you farm fish, you feed them like chicken. And so the amino acid, the acidic composition of their fat will not be with omega-3, will be with omega-6, like chicken. Please follow my seminar on fat quality, because I explained this concept quite good. Same approach of high glucosamine, high chondroitin, even if it is an adult product, high energy density, because this product is powerful for mini and for medium maxi. Also for mini and for medium maxi in the lamb product. So same concept of before. dehydrated lamb, fresh lamb, brown rice, then the source of fat, chicken fat, but also fish oil, pea starch for low glycemic index, dried pumpkin, high integration of glucosamine, chondroitin, taurine, carnitine, etc. In this product, again, all the benefits of our production, steam cooking, for example. And finally, ta-da! Yes, let's make a quick break because then we can speak more thoroughly about Holistic, which is the very, very top product in our production. And one of the, we can say it clearly, one of the best product in the market worldwide. Okay, so thank you very much. Stay with us, reload the page, maybe in 5 minutes so we can have time to relax and go to toilet. And then we connect again for the last part of explanation of our products. Thank you. The recording. Sorry. Good. So we came back with our last part on our products. This is the Holistic, the grain-free ultra premium of the USAPET. Of course, here the characteristic of the products are the most, let's say, advanced. We will have the same goodness, the same pluses of the lower line, plus something more. This product is characterized by, of course, the use of high quality meats, fresh meat, the use of natural antioxidants in very high amount, the steam cooking, the highest level of proteins from animal origin, which means quality again, because you will see that the source of starch are not bringing protein to our products, and the most powerful phytonutrient complex you can ever find into the market. And I'm not joking, and I will explain you why. What is the reason of having phytonutrients, of having botanicals that are very expensive in a pet food, if you cannot make proper claims of efficacy, of functionality? What is the reason? There is not. You are just wasting money. So if you see majority of producer, they are claiming nothing about their phytonutrients, just the presence of them into the formula. In our case, it's very different. Our phytonutrients are so selected, are titrated. You know what is titration? Titration is the definition of exact amount of active compounds inside, alkaloids, flavonoids, terpenoids, all these kind of oils, all they are titrated. We receive for each bag not only the phytonutrient, we are receiving genetic identification of the phytonutrients, because not all aloes are the same. There is just Aloe barbadensis that can be called aloe vera. All other aloes, they are not aloe vera. They have not the same efficacy. And same is for all other ingredients. Our ginseng is the Panax ginseng, is the ginseng Chinese. It's not the Panax quinquefolium, for example. And we know it because we have genetic identification. We have a titration. All our phytonutrients are extremely safe, and I will tell you why. And they can allow us to make claim of efficacy on the bag, something that you will not find in other phytonutrients. All our holistic products, both in dog and in cat, they use a phytonutrient complex as a base. This phytonutrient complex is anti-aging, antioxidant anti-aging complex made of cloves, turmeric, rosemary, lemon, anti-age. On your bag, on all the bags of Holistic, you will find it prevents cellular aging. Very important. You will not find another, you will not find another pet food claiming it prevents cellular aging. All our products. Then, in addition to this powerful phytonutrient complex as a base, we add two different phytonutrients for each, let's say, kind of product. In all our chicken maintenance formula, whether they are for puppies or for adults, we use a combination of ginseng, which is adaptogen, it's anti-fatigue, it's anti-stress, and it's revitalizing, and aloe vera, purified without any toxic compound, exclusively polysaccharide, very active in skin regeneration and immune system boosting. So chicken products, both puppies and adult, which are mini, medium, and maxi, like we saw in natural, so very same, very strict segmentation. All our chicken products will have the same base anti-age complex of rosemary, cloves, turmeric, and lemon, plus ginseng and aloe vera. All the lamb and venison products that are mini and medium maxi in dog and just adult in cat, they are with the same base phytonutrient complex of cloves, rosemary, turmeric, and aloe vera for anti-aging. But also they will have ginseng, adaptogen, relaxant, energizing, and so on. And a very special ingredient in which we are the first in the world to use it in a maintenance pet food, not in treats, not in snacks, in a maintenance pet food. We are the first in the world, which is the medical cannabis sativa. Beautiful ingredient, very selected, without completely without toxicity, completely without the tetrahydrocannabinoid, which is the THC, the psychoactive compound, completely free, with a very high amount of other cannabinoids like the CBD, cannabidiol, the most important. 15 to 20% of our cannabis sativa is cannabidiol. So very high quality, very high safety. And what is the use of this? Again, like with pumpkin, you will find in literature multiple, really huge amount of studies, even if they are, we are far from understanding completely, but in the last 3 years, a huge amount of studies regarding cannabidiol. The most important to know is that they can act at gastroenteric and immune system level to reduce pain, reduce inflammation, calming down. So very beneficial. Then obviously receptors that can express, let's say, the efficacy of the cannabis are also in other systems. They are at nervous system, so calming maybe a little bit, at joint system, then even on neoplastic cells, cancer. But we cannot claim, to be honest, we cannot claim anything about the cannabis because the cannabidiol is not registered as additive for feed, but we use it as ingredient, which is not additive. You remember the difference between composition, ingredients, and additive list? We are not putting in additive list. We are listing, as we will see in the next slide, in the composition, the ingredient of cannabis sativa. We are the unique in the world that use the flower and apical leaves of cannabis sativa. This was the lamb and venison. I repeat, anti-age product complex plus ginseng and cannabis sativa. In the ocean fish, which is mainly herring, very high quality fish, we have again the phytonutrient complex anti-age plus aloe vera, for skin regeneration, for immune system, and so on. And again, cannabis sativa. For the same reason of before, anti-inflammatory, anti-pain. We have the same product in cat line, ocean fish, again with cannabis sativa and aloe vera. And then in cat line, we have other two further products that I will show you later. They are neuter and airball. And they, instead of having, they have different phytonutrient, which is the sugarcane fiber, disaccharified without sugar, but the sugarcane fiber. Very important, first for washing out the airball. So the airball that are not vomited, but they are expelled with the feces, because fiber can stimulate peristalsis, the intestinal movement, and so the washing out of the airballs. And then for the neuter, as we said, for the weight control, fiber is reducing the glycemic index, is reducing the energetic density of the formula. So we make a product that is able to care about the weight of the animal, satiety, which is very, very important in neuter animals. Let's see the product to see the goodness of the formula. This is puppy. As you can see, we can make the calculation of carbohydrates. Do you remember before that very valid ultra premium? It was 22%. In this case, and speaking about average, because this is a European label, not minimum and maximum, that can be tricky, but average, we have 100 minus 38 is 62, minus 22 is 40, minus 1.4 of fiber is 38.5. Minus moisture is 29, minus 8.4 of ash, we are almost at 20. And that's why you see in our label, look at the composition after ash, we even declare the starch. You see, this is a voluntary declaration, because we want to be transparent and we want to show that for us starch is not the problem. Actually, we use starch in a very technical way. Our starch is low glycemic index from sweet potato and from pea starch. Not the entire peas, like that ultra premium of before, that also bring a big part of protein without taurine, without methionine, cysteine, and so on. But starch, only the starch, only the, let's say, low glycemic index sugar to bind the kibble. So very high amount of protein fat, very low amount of starch. And this one is not the formula with less starch. In cat product, we have formulas with less than 15% of starch, guys. So the minimum amount in the market. And then we may speak about the quality of raw material, but we already talked about, you already can judge by yourself. 45% of dehydrated high quality chicken, 20% of deboned fresh chicken, and then 10% of duck. Very high amount of protein from animal origin, because then we have sweet potato. Sweet potato contains 1.5% of protein. Even if we put 10, and we cannot put more than 10 because there is duck immediately before that is already 10. So if we put more than 10 sweet potato, we should put it instead of duck, okay? So 10%, 1.5% of 10% is 0.15% of protein brought by potato. 38% minus 0.15, it's almost, again, 38%. So the majority of protein, almost all proteins in this product proceed from animal origin. That's why they are super rich in taurine already. Even if we add then amount of taurine that is enough for cat also in this product. And then we can talk about, well, pea starch doesn't have protein. And then we have every kind, we have psyllium inside. So we not only have chicory root for inulin, for fruct oligosaccharide. Not only we have selected the inactivated Brewer's yeast for mannano oligosaccharide, we have psyllium, very, very important source of soluble fiber, one of the most important and most advanced source of soluble fiber used in veterinary nutrition. Chondroitin and glucosamine in very high quantity, 1,300 and 1,100, more than majority of prescription diet for joints in the market, more we have in our product, brought in natural way with chicken cartilage. We did this because in USA, they would not allow to put glucosamine and chondroitin in isolate form in puppies because they are recognized as non-essential nutrient. Actually, they should not be used. So since we want to sell a lot also in that important market, we use chicken cartilage, very rich of this glucosamine and chondroitin. And then, as you can see, the exact amount and the exact definition of our phytonutrients. Again, one of the most important part of our label. Aloe vera, 0.10%. Panax ginseng, ginseng root, natural, 0.1%. Very high amount, guys. You may think this is a low amount, but it's huge amount. Check out the products in the market. If they use aloe vera, and sometimes they just use some aloe, not even aloe vera, they will put less than 1/10 of what we put. So 0.01, 0.02, just to have it into the label. And then the powerful phytonutrient complex, rosemary, turmeric, cloves, lemon, 0.05%. Again, very high amount. So we can talk even much, much more about this label. We can talk about the omega-3, 1.3%, that are all from fish oil, not like from vegetal oil like gamma linolenic before, because DHA 0.4, EPA 0.7, the sum is 1.2, 1, so just 0.2 of gamma linolenic, which is good, but we prefer EPA and DHA. Because they are from fish oil, they are even more noble. Again, the splitting of energy in protein and fat, and so on. Very complete label. You will probably not find a more complete label into the market. So this was a puppy product, puppy range, same segmentation of before, mini, medium, maxi. This is a puppy fish. We even have a very good segmentation of puppy fish here, mini, medium, maxi. This is the product also with cannabis sativa and aloe vera. You see cannabis sativa, 0.10 of apical leaves and 0.005% of inflorescence of flower, the richest and noble part, most noble part of cannabis. It's unmatchable. In the market, you will maybe find some product with the cannabis sativa seeds, but seeds have zero active compounds. They are a very noble source of protein to be vegetal origin. They have interesting acidic composition, fat, but phytonutrients, zero. Okay, so cannabis seed, cannabis fiber is not like a cannabis flower like we have in our product. Just take a look at omega-3, 2.8%. This is not huge, more. It's even more than omega-6, the maximum anti-inflammatory power, the maximum development of the brain of the puppies. Very, very important nutrients. Chicken adult, because we saw we have chicken puppy, mini, medium, maxi. We have chicken adult, mini, medium, maxi. Same characteristic of before, same phytonutrients of before, obviously different nutrients, little bit less of protein and of fat compared to puppies, but still this is a product that could be easily administered to a puppy because it complies with all kind of requirements for puppy products that are normally more strict than adult products because puppies can be suffer from this imbalance much more easily than adult. fish product mini, medium, maxi, adult, again with aloe vera and cannabis sativa, part of having the anti-age complex, and lamb product, same concept of before, only in adult, mini and medium maxi, same quality of ingredients, dehydrated lamb, fresh lamb, dehydrated venison, from very North Europe, where the soil is not contaminated with heavy metals. This is the highest quality of venison. It's not like the venison of Middle Europe. Cannabis sativa, again, high quantity, apical leaves, flower, ginseng root, and then the anti-age complex. High quantity of protein, high quantity of fat. It goes by itself, this product is a product, even if there is a very big segmentation in this line, this product is mainly for animals that need a high protein diet. Very ancestral breeds, Alaskan Malamute, Husky, Czech Wolf, Sarlos Wolf, this kind of very primitive breed that can do well with meat. I would not give this product to a very sensitive dog, I don't know, to a bulldog. Maybe he do perfectly, most probably he would do perfectly, but still they are so selected breeds that we destroy them under physiological point of view. They are breeds that cannot even deliver puppies by themselves and they need the veterinarian to open their belly to take out puppies. So just to tell you which point we reach with selection. In this case, maybe this product is not the most indicated. If you want to use this product, it's possible, but you have to reduce the dose, to reduce, because in this way, the protein and fat will not overload their sensitive stomach. These are products for dog. I would like to show you very quickly the products for cat. The products for cat are same of before, as I said, so very high quality ingredients, but probably even more quality. Let's take a look to the amount of carbohydrate in this product, which is the product with super amount of protein and fat, 44% of protein from meats, not from vegetals, not from peas, from meats. 20% of fat. If we would make the calculation, we have 17% of starch, 1/7. In this product, the amount of carbohydrate is limited to the very, very minimum to keep the kibble in shape, to bind the kibble, the very minimum amount. And then the same goodness of before, as we said, phytonutrient complex, fresh meat, natural antioxidant. In this product, the taurine amount, since it is product for cat, it's four times the amount recommended by the institution. We have 4,000 milligrams per kilo, huge amount of taurine, even if almost entirely our protein proceed from animal, we have a huge amount of taurine. Then we have a chicken adult, slightly below in protein and fat, but still, if you see at the carbohydrate, 19% of starch, extremely good, low amount. And then we have lamb and venison, as before, with cannabis sativa and ginseng and anti-age property, with slightly lower protein. Fish, again with cannabis sativa, aloe vera, and anti-age phytonutrient with very high omega-3, 2.6, as you can notice. In this case, I didn't mention, but in all fish product, there is no chondroitin, there is just glucosamine, because we didn't use chicken cartilage. We use green lipid muscle that all of you know, being very extremely good chondroprotector, rich in glucosamine. That's why you will find only glucosamine 1000. And then the two special products, Airball and Neuter. Again, products with very high level of protein, with high level of fat, the Airball, but with low level of fat, the Neuter. Yes, there is a mistake, not a Haribol, but a Hairball. With a lower level of fat in neuter, because we don't want to overweight them. And then with a high level of fiber for both products, because fiber can, in the case of Hairball, you see 8% of fiber, can wash out the Hairball with feces, not with vomiting. And in neuter can reduce the energetic density of the ratio and also give satiety feeling, reducing even the glycemic index. And we are the first pet food in the world, thanks to our sugarcane fiber, that can write on the package of the neuter product low glycemic index. All the rest of pet food, they just could not, because the glycemic index in pet medicine is not defined. You can make it only by comparison, but our sugarcane fiber is so special that allow us to write that it reduced the glycemic index of the formula. So, Hairball, anti-age property, anti-age complex, aloe vera, because it reminds the skin care, the Hairball problem, and the sugarcane fiber for washing out the ball of fur. And then in neuter, ginseng to give a push of energy to the neuter animal that very often they are, let's say, more lazy, and the sugarcane fiber in order to reduce the energetic density and the glycemic index of the formula. So guys, I think that mostly we are done with the product presentation, because then I will reserve in future a dedicated training for prescription diets that will be, as you can expect, even more innovative than what you saw so far with maintenance pet food, that it's already, I would say, very innovative. Now, I think we have a few minutes for labor reading, for question and answer, and then we can update by mail. You can follow, I really please ask you to follow my webinars on YouTube. They are in English, with my poor Italian English, but I hope understandable. They are important because you are nutritional consultant, you are not seller. You are nutritional consultant. You will need to know nutrition in order to suggest the best solution. For sure, you know already a lot, but still there is a lot to learn. Me too, I'm learning every day, and I want to share the nutritional knowledge with you. So please follow our YouTube channel, because each week, each 2 weeks, there is a new video updated. In this moment, they are already a lot. Now, I would stop the sharing and recording, and I am available for the remaining time for a question. Thank you.